Okay, we are getting started again on the PE cough visualizer, the bin dash project for the Handmade Network Wheel Reinvention Jam. As usual, if you are here hanging out because you think my projects are cool and you haven't done so yet, think about going to mrforth.com/membership and looking at the perks and decide maybe if maybe you could become a monthly or yearly member or supporter of the lab. That people who do that keep the projects going. And it's much appreciated. So, looking at the to-do today, I'm trying to decide where the next best step to go is. And I think there's a lot. There's a lot of options, and I can't do it all during the jam. There's trying to get more of the content in there. I think header could fit in today if I wanted it to. Because we could use the table system to show the header, or we could talk about like doing the header as, right? I could do the header as a table, or I could do it as a folder with subsections in it for different parts of the header. But what we're missing that I think is bigger is the ability to have views other than the table view, and then do correlations between them. So I think stuff like this is important. And in order to get to here, we need to have the parser get into better shape. And I was kind of partway through upgrading the parser yesterday. So I think today what I want to do is I'm going to set aside making progress on the visualizer entirely and just keep on trucking on up making this parser more powerful, because I can't visualize data that I don't have, and the parser is what gives me data from the input file. So I think that this needs to be the focus if I really want to make another big step forward on what the visualizer can do. And that means there's not going to be a lot of GUI work until maybe some of this other stuff has been sorted. And I think the right mood for refactoring is something chill and soft and quiet. So I'm going to put on some lo-fi work music. And I'm going to just start thinking about what I can do to improve the parser factorization and features. I want to eliminate these and replace it with something else. All right, let's rewrite the header parse here. Okay, so we run into this problem where we don't know We don't know if we have an object file or not. This is gonna be hard. The object files just don't really come with a magic signature or anything to help you recognize them, which is weird. Okay. I'm trying to figure out the best way to report errors. If I take a pointer, then I need to know the base pointer of the data range. If I take an offset, then I can do cough off, but I have harder time doing members, right? Then I have to do offset of member. PE cough header machine type, right? That's so much. Excuse me. That's so much more work than this in terms of code maintenance. Thank you. Serious Python, hey, it's going all right. I'm working on making the parser a lot more powerful so I can do like proper diagnostics messages and mapping ranges onto the file contents and stuff like that. So what I'm doing here, for anyone who's following and wondering, is that, like, I'm breaking this up into smaller steps, and each small step will have the opportunity to make a little bit of progress and also to validate things more carefully, which is how I'm going to generate more diagnostics messages as I do the parse. Hey, Celia, thanks for the subscription. Thank you. Okay, I think. Go ahead and say we don't want to be doing that all over the place. It's kind of annoying. Okay. So we make sure that the signature will fit. Okay, so now Okay, we are actually not going to check the PE signature again here. We already checked that up here. Now we're just going to ignore it. Well, that doesn't make a lot of sense. Just rewrite this part, I suppose. That should be all we need. Interesting. All right, cool. Everything still seems to work. Let's keep going. None of this quite works as well as I would like for it to. gonna have to do another whole pass over this several times to get it to a good state, but let me go for now. I think now would be a good time for me to take my break. I've been at it for about an hour and a half. I think where this is at is, like, I've gotten about halfway through it, as in not necessarily halfway through the code. There's more lines of code that I haven't touched, but I've made enough examples of what this will be like that I could now go and start visualizing these errors. But there are a couple of other things that will prevent me from getting there, right? So I need to build out the visual side of the error system, and I need some samples of broken files to actually see any of these code paths get hit. So I think the right next step is going to be to stop where I'm at. Don't go through and finish refactoring everything just yet, but to see how this looks on the other end. And if it doesn't look quite right, then I can make some tweaks now before I go and write another 600 lines of refactors to put in errors that I'm just going to end up not liking. Does that make sense? So I'm thinking the plan here is I take my break. When I come back, we'll switch gears from adding in the error diagnostic stuff to the parser, and we'll switch over to generating some files that can actually go through the system and spit out errors, and then making the visualization information for these errors. So let's do that. Oh, it looks like hello, I just saw your chat as I was signing off. It's nice to see you. I'm just taking a break. I'll be back in like 30 minutes or so to keep up the jam work on this project, but it's break time for now. So I'll see you in a bit.